Welcome, and thank you for joining us. You will hear Mathew James, Eleanor Kelly, then we will have an interval, and you will hear young and up-and-coming Argentinian guitarist Youree Delvalle, and then after that, we will have myself. I am the artistic director of the Classical Minds Festival. And we will finish the concert with Argentinian guitarist Daniela Rossi, who currently lives in England. Today was a very intense day for the participants who've learned a lot. And this was an extension of the festival that occurred in April. So please enjoy the show. And if you would be so kind to donate a ticket, you can leave it in the tip jar on the classicalmindsfestival.org. That's our festival website. Or after the concert, below the video, you will see that I've added the link to the tip jar as well. So thank you.
Hi there, I'm Mathew James. For this Classical Minds concert, I'll be playing Hirokazu Sato's Sonatine No. 2, more commonly known as the Autumn Sonatina. This piece was originally written in 1994 for the guitarist Hiroyuki Enomoto, who premiered the piece that same year in Tokyo. Enomoto had originally commissioned Sato to compose a small piece with an autumn mood. This would become the second movement of the Sonatina, which had the original name Autumn Song. Sato had stated that the first and third movements may not be very autumn-like, but regardless of these autumn moods, this wonderful sonatina has been a hidden gem of the guitar repertoire for far too long. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Eleanor Kelly and I'm so excited to play for you now as part of tonight's larger concert with three other fabulous classical guitarists and fellow members of the Classical Minds Guitar Festival faculty, Valerie Hartzell, Daniela Rossi and Mathew James. The first piece I'd like to play is Seascape by Phyllis Tate, who was a 20th century English composer. This is one of her two solo guitar works and is inspired, of course, by the sea. And in the score, there's markings like foghorn, tidal interlude, and sea shanty. So hopefully you can hear these characters in this next piece, Seascape. The next piece I'll play is the second movement from the Sonatina by Teresa de Rogatis, who was an Italian composer but spent most of her career in Egypt, which is where she wrote this Sonatina in around 1944. As I said, she spent most of her career in Egypt, and so lots of her compositions were written in Egypt for guitar. She was a guitarist herself and also a pianist, and was really influenced by a lot of impressionist music. You can really hear these beautiful colours and chords in this second movement. Mm-hmm. I'd like to finish with a candombe called Cielo Abierto. Candombe is a type of music and dance originally from Uruguay. And this piece, Cielo Abierto, is originally by Kike Senesi, an Argentine guitarist. And this version was arranged for classical guitar by Victor Villadangos. So thank you for tuning in to this evening's concert. I'm sure you enjoyed the other performances from Valerie, Daniela and Mathew. And if you attended the workshop this afternoon, I hope you also enjoyed that. So thank you once again.
Thank you. Hello everyone, my name is Youree. I live in Buenos Aires, Argentina. I'm very happy to participate once again in this festival, which is Classical Guitar Seminars. I'm going to play for you two arrangements for guitar. I hope you like it. Thank you.
La Luna Verde by Ernesto Tamayo. This is a very good friend of mine. He's originally from Cuba, and we were students at the same time of Manoa Barueco at the Peabody Conservatory. And of course, internet was not a thing back when I was in school. I just started getting email. It wasn't until I moved to Houston years later that I got back in touch with Ernesto and we rekindled our friendship. And he was also like a mentor to me. He performed for the Concert Guild I used to direct in Katy, Texas, outside of Houston. And he came there twice, I believe. And he came to the Classical Minds, back when it was the Classical Minds International Guitar Festival and Competition. And I know he came at least once to that. And then he came to Alaska and we went on tour together. It was loads of fun. When he came to Alaska, to Anchorage, where I used to live, he brought some of his music. It was a recently published score of his own solos. He does have a CD of these same pieces of music arranged for orchestra and solo classical guitar. Obviously, I don't have an orchestra in my house, so you will be hearing the solo version of this piece. Unfortunately, after he left Alaska, he was diagnosed with cancer, and that would have been the last time I saw him. And the guitar world has lost an incredible musician and, of course, such a wonderful human being. He was a dear person, very modest, and very funny. It's taken many years for me to be able to play his music. It was just too emotional. So I'm so glad that I'm going to be able to share with you many of his compositions, and we're going to start with this prelude. A Deep Purple Mirror is by my friend Mathew James, who is also one of the faculty at the Classical Minds Guitar Festival and the workshop today. He wrote these in April, actually, and I premiered the first two movements at a guitar concert program in Argentina, an online concert. And today will be the world premiere of the third movement. And I'm going to play the second and third movement for you today. This is my own composition, Blackbirds, and I have this as part of my adventures during lockdown suite. And this, most of these adventures were taking place either in my garden or in the fields next to my house back in Marston, Mauritain, or in the forest center, and also in the village I used to live in. There are two themes you need to listen for. This is the male blackbird, or the call of the male blackbird. And then there is the call of the female blackbird. So two very simple themes. All you need to know is that the male blackbird is looking for his mate. And there were times when you would get very, very quiet. There'd be singing, the birds would be singing, the blackbirds would be calling to each other, and then it would just be dead silence. And normally that was because there was a hawk around. And so I added that at the end of the piece. I do a little double tremolo, and then I stop. And then in the distance is the tremolo, as if the bird's warning in the distance, careful. And then everything is quiet. And then there's a tentative call of the blackbird, and then the female responds. And then in the end, they get together and they mate and have lots of babies, and they're very happy and fly away together. So it's a happy ending.
Hello everyone, and thank you for being here. Thank you for watching, for the support, and also huge thanks to Valerie for inviting me again to Classical Minds for the third time and the second time in the online format. I hope you're enjoying the concerts. It's a pleasure also to be taking part of the workshop. Also to be sharing the stage with Mathew and Eleanor and Valerie, of course. The program I'm going to do today is starting with a piece by Giulio Regondi, Introduction and Capricci, a romantic composer. Then two etudes by Francisco Tárrega, Studio di Velocità and Studio Brillante. Then a small beautiful prelude by Mexican composer Manuel María Ponce, prelude in D sharp minor number 14. And finally, I will end the concert with the new Folias based on the Asian theme, the Folia of Spain, that British composer Vincent Lindsey-Clark dedicated to me, and I premiered earlier this year. So it's a pleasure to perform this fantastic piece again for you. And I really hope you enjoy the concert. Thank you again.